Hello, I'm Chris Daughtry. I'm the lead vocalist of the band Daughtry. I also play guitar, and I also draw comic book stuff. I'm an artist as well, and I like long walks in the park.
My name is Brian Craddock. I play with Chris in Daughtry, and I play rhythm guitar. I'm a Virgo, and I love music a lot.
Walks in the park with me.
And walks in the park, but not with him.
I'm really, really high on myself, and I'm an egotistical SOB. Well, we could have came out with a really obscure name, but coming from the TV show and having name recognition, it was easier just to go with my last name.
Steely Dragon.
Steely Dragon would have been great. Rainbow Butt Monkeys would have also been great, but that was taken. The identity of the band. That's a good question.
I think it's a pretty easy question, Chris. No, I think a lot of what this band is known for is his lyrics. I think that kind of goes in conjunction with the other question: what sets us apart? And I think it's the ability to connect through topics that are accessible, stuff that everybody would deal with. Getting something that gets away from, you know, political agendas and so on. And we have so much of that now that you don't need it rammed into your free time as well. And music, for a lot of people, that is their free time. So to have something that is easy to understand and not so complex, at least not on a worldly scale, I think is a nice thing for a lot of people to be able to escape from, you know, their life and dive into a story that might be there for somebody else. So,
wow.
That was deep.
That was awesome.
That's good.
You heard it here from Brian Craddock, folks. Still remember all the stupid things that I've said and done, but still you're stuck. I hardly ever have any kind of disputes or... I mean, it's weird because we're all very different, but we're all very much alike. I think the fact that we are so different in so many ways, I think it's easier. If we're all exactly the same, I think we would hate each other because everybody would have, you know, the biggest ego. But none of that exists in this band. We all get along great. I mean, every now and then, you know, somebody's going to say something that gets on your nerves or you're going to do something that rubs somebody the wrong way, but we're also adults, and we know how to handle each other and everyone else involved, so it's easy. The weird thing is, with this record, you know, these guys weren't on the record, so we're basically playing what's already been recorded live, so sometimes someone will want to do something different to change it up a little bit or maybe make it more interesting for the live show. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, and sometimes you may think it doesn't work where the other guy thinks it's awesome. As long as you're big enough to just suck in your pride and deal with it like an adult, it should never be an issue. I was the only one in the band that was in the studio that time when Slash was recording. It was definitely a great experience, just, you know, sitting down and watching him, you know, play and do his thing. Someone that you grew up, you know, listening to, like, he's a guitar icon. Our drummer Joey, I would have to say.
I think maybe a little bit of Chris Daughtry, too.
you know, what can I say?